Hello friends, in this lecture we will discuss about the splitting of F term under octahedral and tetrahedral environment of any D configuration. So splitting of DN configuration and splitting of F term into different Mulliken terms due to the environment of central metal atom that may be tetrahedral or may be octahedral. So we will take an example of configuration with F term. So there are four configurations, 4D configurations with F term, that are D2, D7, D3 and D8. These four configurations, they have ground state term F. So we will take first D2. Example we will take. So in case of D2, we have already calculated its ground state term. So we again calculate its ground state term, that S is equal to the total spin is equal to 1, because there are two unpaired electrons, L will equals to 3, so multiplicity will equal to, according to 1, S is equal to 1, multiplicity becomes 3, because this is L, L is equal to 3, so term will be F and multiplicity is 3. So the ground state term will be 3F. So this 3F term is the atomic term for D2 configuration. So if we take 2F as the ground state term, this is the atomic term. In octahedral field, this the configuration, that is D2 configuration, that will split into T2G and EG. So in the ground state, two electrons are unpaired, so this is ground state term. In excited state, there are two excited states, so one excited state is that one electron will transfer to the EG set, this is EG, this is T2G. And in the second excited state, both the electrons, they will transfer into EG set. So this is excited state and this is also excited state. So now we'll take one by one. First we will take the ground state term. So if we see the ground state term, in case of ground state term, T2G is asymmetrically filled. So there is three possibility of arranging these two electrons in T2G set. So they may be here or they may be here. So there are three possibilities. So this ground state term will be T, triple E generate, because there are three possibilities. So it is T. It is generating from multiplicity 2. So it is 2T. The next state is this one, excited state. So if you will see the excited state, we can see that this excited state has 6 combinations. It can be written as like this. One electron can be here and this electron can be here. So these are the two conditions. Then other condition is this electron may be here or this electron may be here. Then this electron maybe here, this electron may be here, or the electron may be here. These are the four possibilities, or the fifth possibility is that this electron may be here or this may be here, and sixth possibility is that this electron is there and this may be there. So there are 6 possibilities. For 6 possibilities, there are no terms. There are only 3 terms. One is A, one is T, and one is E. So this is singly degenerate. This is triply degenerate. And this is doubly degenerate. No term is there for 6 degeneration. So these 6 combinations they may have two T terms. These are the combination of two T terms. So 2T. So these two T terms, then we will see the next excited state. In case of next excited state, like this, so we can see that there is only one possibility. Only one possibility. So this state is A. So this is A state. Now we will write the complete diagram, splitting diagram of F term. So this is F term, and this F term, then in presence of octahedral field, this is the ground state term for D2 configuration. This is the excited state, first excited state, and this is the second excited state. So this state is T. This state is the combination of 2T. And this state is A because there is only one possibility. So there is only one possibility, this is A. So as we know that in Mulliken terms, in case of F, it splits into A2 plus T1 plus T2. So the Mulliken terms will be T2, T1 and T2. Now we can see that degeneracy of F term will be S, like F orbital. F orbital has seven orbitals, so its degeneracy is 7. So likewise, the degeneracy of the F term will be 7. Now we will see the degeneracy of this Mulliken terms. This will have the degeneracy of 3 because it's triply degenerate. This will also have 3 degeneracy, this will also have 3 degeneracy, and this will have 1 degeneracy. So total degeneracy is equal to 10. While the term F has degeneracy 7 and the Mulliken terms, they are having the degeneracy 10. So it means there is one extra T term. So this extra T term is from P term, is of P term. So 7 of F and 3 of P, it becomes 10. So total degeneracy of 3F and 3P is 10, and the Mulliken term is also equals to 10. So now, this F term, we have to remember this, that the T1G term is also, always, it comes either lowest energy level or highest energy level. Likewise, A2 may be highest energy term, or maybe of lowest energy term, and T2 will always be in between these two terms. So we have to remember this for the splitting of F term. So if we will see, so we have to always take P term along with F term, then we can show the splitting of F term. So now we can see that 2F term, so I already discuss this, that the T1G term, this will always be maybe the highest or the lowest energy term. So 3T1G will be the lowest energy term here, because 3T is the lowest energy term here in case of D2 configuration, and in case the T2G term will remain always in between the terms T1G and A2G, and A2G will remain always will remain higher, highest or lowest. And the fourth term, that is again 1T term, that was generated from P term, so that will be the T1G term. So this is the term that is generated from P, and these three terms, these three Mulliken terms, they are generated from F term. So total degeneracy becomes 10, and total degeneracy becomes 10. So in case of F term, we have to always write another term, that is P, so that the degeneracy of these atomic terms, they become to the degeneracy of these Mulliken terms. Now we will take example of D7 configuration. So if we'll take D7 example, so in case of D7, again we can calculate the ground state term. We have already calculated the ground state term. So in case of D7 configuration, I think the multiplicity will be different. So there are 3 unpaired electrons. So S is equal to 3 by 2. Multiplicity will become 4. L is equal to plus 2 plus 2 plus 4 plus 1 plus 1 plus 6, 0 minus 1 minus 3. So it becomes 3. So again this term becomes 4F. Multiplicity is different, but the term is F. In case of D7 configuration, the term again becomes F. So 4F, this is D4 configuration. This is D7 configuration. This is D7 configuration. So in this case, the ground state will be like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the ground state term. Then first excited term, 1, 2, 3, 4. In first excited term, one electron from here will transit to here. Then second excited state is like this. So this is the second excited state. So in this case, we can again see that D2G is asymmetrically filled. So we can also write the configuration of this term. That is D2G5EG2. Configuration of this term is D2G4EG3. Configuration of this term is D2G3EG4. So now because it is asymmetrically filled, this term is T. Which T? T1G, because I have already told that you have to remember only about the terms T1G and A2G, which may be the highest term, which may be the lowest term, and T2G will remain in between these two terms always. And this EG is also asymmetrical and T2G is also asymmetrical. So its degeneracy is 2, its degeneracy is 3. So 3 into 2 is equal to 6. So their degeneracy is 6. Again, the term may be T1G plus T2G. So this T1G is generated from P term and this is of F term, and this is both are symmetrically filled, so only one possibility is there. So this term is A. This is A2G. So in case of D7 configuration, this will split like this. The F term will split like this, and we can write it, the splitting can be written as this. The 4F term will split into 4T1G, then T2G will remain always in between the two terms, then it is A2G, and then 4P1 term is also there, that is 4T1G. This is from P and this is from F. So we will discuss about this point, that why they are crossing each other. So we will discuss later in the later lectures. Now we will take the example of D3 configuration. So we can discuss about the D3 configuration. So in case of D3 configuration, the arrangement, the ground state term is F. It is 4F again. So 4F configuration, after forming octahedral complex, it becomes like this. So in case of 4F configuration, the 3 electrons, D3 configuration, the 3 electrons will arrange like this in the ground state. In the excited state, the 1 electron will transfer to EG set. And in the second excited state, this will again, the second electron will also transfer to this state. So now we can see that both are symmetrically filled. Only one possibility is there, so it becomes A. So what A? Because F term will split into A to G. So this is A to G term. Then it is also asymmetrically filled, it is also asymmetrically filled, so degeneracy will become 6 again. So these are T1G plus T2G. These are the Mulliken terms. Then we can see that this is asymmetrically filled, T2G is asymmetrically filled, so it has 3 possibility of arrangement, so it becomes T. Now it is T, so we have already known that A2G or T1G, they may be the highest energy term or lowest energy sum, so this is 4T1G. So in this case, we can see that in case of D3 configuration, the splitting pattern of F term is entirely different from that of d7 configuration. Both have three unpaired electrons, but the splitting pattern is different because they have different configurations. So in this case, the splitting pattern is like this. So the lowest energy term is A2G here, the middle term is T2G, and the highest term is T1G of F, and one term we have to take, that is 4F. So it has 4T1G. So this is T1G of P and this is T1G of F. We can also write the configurations like this is the configuration T2G3. This configuration is T2G2EG1. So these two terms, they are generated from the first excited state. So its configuration is also T2G2EG1. And for this, this is the second excited state. So the configuration will become T2G1EG2. So we can write the configurations as well as and the splitting pattern of this configuration. So we will take the example of D8 configuration. We will see that D8 configuration is just like the splitting pattern is just like the D3 configuration. And we can show this. So in case of D8 configuration, again the term the ground state term is 3F. This is the atomic term, and in presence of octahedral field, it becomes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is the ground state term. The first excited state term is like this, and the second excited state is like this. So that in this state, both are symmetrically filled. This EG and the T2G set. So it is A2G. One singly degenerate. Its degeneracy is 6. So again, there are two states, T1G and T2G. These are having 3 multiplicity. And in this case, this T2G is asymmetrically filled. So there are 3 possibilities. So the term become T. So this is T1G again. So now we can again draw the splitting pattern of 3F term of D8 configuration. So we can see that it is more similar to the pattern of D3 configuration. So it only the change in the multiplicity. So this is T1G, this is A2G, this is 3 T2G, T2G will always remain in the center. This is 3 T1G of F, and this is 3 T1G of P. So we will discuss later about this pattern of T1G and T1G in this splitting. So we can conclude it like that D2 and D7 configuration and D3 and D8 configuration. All the 4 configurations, they have F state, and D2 and D7 have the similar pattern, and D3 and D8 octahedral complexes, they have the similar pattern. So now we can compare it with the splitting pattern of tetrahedral complex. So we can compare the splitting of tetrahedral, splitting of D2 configuration with the octahedral splitting. So we will discuss about only one configuration difference. So we will take the example of D2 configuration. So we have already seen the splitting of D2 configuration in octahedral field. Now we will see the splitting pattern of D2 configuration in tetrahedral field. So in tetrahedral field, again, the ground state term will remain the same, 3F. This is the atomic term. And when the tetrahedral complex will be formed, the splitting pattern will be entirely different from that of octahedral field. Now, the E will remain the lowest state and T2 will be the highest state. So now the 2 electrons are filled in E set. So the configuration will become E2. After excitation, the 1 electron will transfer to the T2 set. And in the second excitation, the 2 electrons will transfer. The 2 electron will transfer to the T2 set. Now, this the configuration becomes E1, T1 and here T2. So now in the ground state term, all the orbitals, they are filled symmetrically. So only one possibility is there. So state become 3A2. In case of first excited state, it is asymmetrically filled, it is also asymmetrically filled, so degeneracy becomes 6. So now this is the combination of two terms, T1 and T2. In this case, it is asymmetrically filled. This T2 is asymmetrically filled, so there are three possibilities. Now the term become 3T1. So T1 or A2, they may be the highest term or the lowest term. So now the splitting of D2 term become like this, that the A2 term will be the lowest term and T2 will be the highest term. So in tetrahedral field, the splitting of F term will like this, that 3A2 will be the lowest term, then 3T2 will be always the middle term, then 3T1 will be the highest term, then there is also one term that is 3T1 again, and this is of P and this comes from 3P. So this will be the splitting pattern of tetrahedral complex having D3 configuration. So now we can compare with the splitting of, this is the tetrahedral complex, and for octahedral complex again we can discuss 3F term will split into 3T1. So in this case 3T1 is the lowest energy term, 3T2 is the middle term, and 3A2 is the highest energy term, and one term is there, that is 3T1 of P. This is from P, this is from F. So we can compare the octahedral. This configuration is D2. So this is D2 tetrahedral and this is D2 octahedral. So we can see that in case of tetrahedral complex, this is the lowest energy term, and in case of octahedral complex, this is the highest energy term. In case of octahedral complex, this is the lowest energy term, and in case of tetrahedral, this is the highest energy term. So we can see that they are just opposite. The splitting pattern of octahedral and tetrahedral is just opposite to each other. It means for each configuration, because we see that the splitting pattern of d orbital is just opposite for tetrahedral and for octahedral field, so their splitting pattern will be the just opposite of each other. So in case of each F term for D2 configuration, for D3, for D7, for D8, the splitting pattern of octahedra and tetrahedra complex are entirely different. So we can conclude the splitting pattern of each state in any configuration like this. We have seen that in case of when the ground state term was D, like for the configurations D1, D6, D4 and D9, these are having D term, multiplicity may be different. And these term D2, D7, D3 and D8, they have F term, multiplicity may be different. So we have already seen that D1 configuration splitting pattern was similar to D6, D4 splitting was similar to D9, D2 was similar to D7 and D3 was similar to D8 for octahedral complex. And that will be reversible for tetrahedral complexes. So we can summarize like this, that D N and D10, DN plus 5. These are similar. D1, D6, DN, DN plus 5, D4, D9, DN, DN plus 5. They have similar pattern, similar splitting pattern. Now we can see that DN and D10 minus N, like D1 and D9. They have opposite inverse splitting pattern. So if they are octahedral, then they will have opposite splitting pattern. And in case of DN octahedra and D10 minus N tetrahedra, because these are inverse, so these are equal. So pattern of DN octahedra and D10 minus D10 minus N tetrahedra, they will be similar pattern, or we can say that DN octahedra and DN plus 5 tetrahedra, they will have inverse splitting pattern. So these are the different splitting pattern of tetrahedra and octahedra fields, and we can also show the splitting pattern of all the these configuration in a single diagram. So single diagram we can draw the splitting pattern of D state, D term and F term in a single diagram. So we can see that if this is ND, so this is ND state. In one case ND state will split into ND2 and NE. In another cases it can split into NE and NT2. In some cases E may be the lowest energy term, in some cases T2 may be the lowest energy term. So in what cases? In D1 configuration, D1 octahedra. In D1 octahedra, T2 was the lowest energy term. So because we know that Dn plus 5, all D6, they have similar pattern octahedra. And in case of D4 and D9 octahedra complexes, E is the lowest energy term and T2 is the highest energy term. Or we can also know that this octahedra is just opposite to tetrahedra. So this is also the diagram for D4 tetrahedra and D9 tetrahedra. So in case of D4, D9 tetrahedra, it is opposite to that of D4 octahedra and D4, D9 octahedra. So T2 will be the of lower energy term. And likewise, this D, this can also be written for D1 tetrahedra and D6 tetrahedra. So this diagram is for four configurations, D1, D4, D6, D9, that have the D term, that have D ground state term. Then we can give the splitting pattern of F in single diagram for four configurations which have F term as the ground state term. So this is NP. So in some cases the lowest energy term is A2 and the highest energy term may be T1. Then this will have T1 state. This is of P, this is of F, and this is the middle term is always T2. In some cases T1 may be the ground state term, then T2 will be the center term, then A2G, A2 will be the highest energy term, and this T1 of P can be here. So this pattern, the D1, the T1 will be the ground state term for D2 octahedra, and D2 is similar as D7 octahedra. These are the this is the splitting pattern for D3 and D7, D3 and D8 octahedra. So likewise we can say that this is the D3 and D8 tetrahedra pattern also. This is for D2 and D7 tetrahedra. So now we can conclude that D1, D6, D4 and D9, which have D as the ground state term, they can be split into two Mulliken terms, T2 and E, and four configurations, D2, D7, D3 and D8, which have F term, they can be split into terms like A2, T2 and T1. And this will, this splitting will be helpful in the formation of orbital diagrams, because if we know the splitting pattern, if we understand the splitting pattern, then we can easily draw the orbital diagrams for any configuration. So in the next lecture, we will discuss first about the non-crossing rule. Then in the, after that, we will discuss about the orbital diagrams. So thank you very much.